he said, "Can I ask you a question?" And then he started saying he was rushing a fraternity and he needed to ask a bunch of questions. And then his final question was that he needed to, like, see and touch my belly button.
The Fox 8 I team obtained this Stowe 911 call made in July.
But it was just really creepy.
The call was made just days after Greg Burrier was taken off a GPS monitoring system. Shortly after the call, Burrier was charged with violating probation. He pleaded guilty to that charge Wednesday. He has been on probation since pleading guilty to a sexual battery charge in 2012.
He has not been successful on probation. He went to prison, he was given judicial release, and he continues to ignore and to violate the restrictions probation has placed on him.
Burrier's defense attorney told the court his client has autism and wants him to go to a residential treatment facility instead of prison. Prosecutors disagree.
No. Okay. No, from the reports we've had access to, and that there's nothing there.
The prosecutors stressed they do not believe Burrier has autism.
He has a history of some developmental issues. He was in some special education classes, but he does not meet any of the diagnosis or criteria to be classified as autistic.
Prosecutors say Burrier is banned from going to parks alone, and he's not allowed to go to the campuses of Kent State University or the University of Akron. We went to Burrier's home Thursday to talk about the case. But a person came to the door and refused to talk to us. Prosecutors believe Burrier belongs behind bars, saying since 2007 there have been multiple instances where Burrier is accused of approaching women and asking to touch their belly buttons.
He chose again this year to go out and again to attempt to touch a woman's belly button as she's running on the bike trail.
In-